We were talking about sharing three tips. You have three tips for a better public speaking. Could you share those with us?
Yeah, the number one, and this is very easy for people to do, is when you're speaking to people, address them and connect with them with your hands open, your palms up, your palms facing them to some degree. Think of this. If I were to beg you for food or water, mm-hmm. how would my hands be?
They
would be out extended and open to you.
Yep.
That's the way every culture communicates with each other when they really want to do it. Some people will keep their hands down. Some people will make fists. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, that does just the opposite of what they're trying to accomplish. Another one you mentioned, is it true to look over people's heads and you don't become as nervous?
Yeah.
Actually, no. You look them right in the eye.
Okay.
And the more you look them in the eye, the more you'll get back from them. If they're agreeing with you, if they're going along with what you're saying, even if they're questioning you, it lets you know how to react to them. So you look them in the eye, and if it's a large group, you just go from section to section to section. If it's a smaller group, you can actually look each individual in the eye, and that just makes the communication engagement. And engagement is number one. It makes the engagement that much more powerful.
Wow. Thank you. So thank you for clearing that up, because I was always told, you look over the crowd, and if you happen to look down, picture them in their underwear.
Yeah. Really? Do you really want to picture a crowd in its underwear?
No.
No, that's a lot to take in. That's too much to take in. I'll be very distracted.
I have no idea where that ever came from, but that's one of the most ridiculous things I've ever heard.
What do you think is that third, solid point?
Preparation.
Preparation?
It's easiest. Preparation. Knowing what you're going to say, knowing how you're going to use your body while you're talking, knowing how you're going to effectively use your voice, which is your most precious tool, mm-hmm. to connect with those people, to get their attention from moment one. You have 10 seconds from the moment you walk on stage or introduced to have people decide whether they want to listen or not, whether they have confidence in you or not. 10 seconds. Most of us haven't opened our mouths by that time. So a lot of it is the body language.
So I'm going to ask you one more. All right. So you're walking on this stage. You've got a crowd of, say, 5 people or 500 people or 5,000 people looking at you. Most of most of what we do is body language. Is there something you would do as far as body language to kind of snag their attention?
Yeah. I'll give you an example. I just finished working with the speakers at TEDx Newport. It took place.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it just took place. And one of the things I taught them was, you don't come out and in TEDx, you stand on this big red dot. You don't come out walking and looking at the dot. As soon as you come out of the wings, you look at the audience, a small smile on your face, a look of confidence, carry yourself with confidence, and you get on that dot. And then you just wait 2 to 4 beats, which is just 1, 2, 3, 4, and then you open your mouth.
Wow.
And that just shows the audience that you have that confidence and that they should want to listen to you.
Sometimes silence pulls people in.
Greatest thing you can say is nothing.
I would agree.